Welcome to Analytic Frameworks for International Public Policy Decisions. I'm Professor Carolyn Gideon. Most Fletcher students, after graduating, at some point, find themselves in positions where they must make very difficult decisions. And these are important decisions that impact many people with very real, significant consequences. Very often, these decisions are about policy issues. I designed this class to prepare you for that moment when you are the one who's facing these very important, very difficult decisions. This class gives you the tools that, along with the knowledge that you build in your field at Fletcher and in your careers, will help you make better decisions at that time. This is a class about public policy analysis and about decision making under uncertainty. We focus on policy decisions, and policy decisions are the most difficult decisions for three reasons. The first reason is that policy decisions always have multiple objectives. There are difficult decisions in business, but in business, you always ultimately have just one objective, and that is to maximize stakeholder value. But in policy decisions, you never have just one objective. And sometimes the objectives you have are in conflict with each other. So that makes the decisions more difficult. The second thing that makes policy decisions more difficult are that there are often resources, sometimes vast resources, devoted to influencing the decisions. And the third thing that makes policy decisions the most difficult are that you will never have all the information you need at the time that you have to make the decision. So you're always making your decisions with some amount of uncertainty. And that makes quantitative analysis particularly important. You're going to have to move beyond the rhetoric and use quantitative analysis to complement any type of qualitative analysis that you've done for solving this problem. The objective, the sole objective of this class, is to make you a better problem solver and a better decision maker. And in this class, we do that. You'll do that by developing a collection of quantitative tools and techniques. And that includes some modeling skills and some decision-making techniques. You're going to apply them to a variety of different policy areas. We learn the skills that are most useful and are very generalizable to all different policy areas. And you will be doing problems and cases from many different countries. One of the most important things that you'll learn in this class is the role of modeling and analysis in policy decision making. You're going to learn what the models can do for you, but you're also going to learn their limitations. Models are never going to be substitutes for thinking and for judgment. And this is a theme that we have throughout the class. You'll hear me bring it up often. So the expectations for this class, first of all, there are no prerequisites. We will use a lot of tools that come from economics and from statistics, but I'll teach you everything from economics and statistics that you need to know. Students who have some prior classes or experience with economics and statistics do not do better than students in this class than students who do not have that prior experience. And often students who have advanced degrees in either economics or statistics still take this class and find it very useful because they're learning some things that have the same name, but they've learned it previously as a theory. And in this class, they're learning it as a technique or as a tool to actually solve problems. And that's often very different. We do use math in this class, but I will not be teaching you any new math. You already know the math that we use. And I know this sometimes causes some anxiety because some of you have been very successfully avoiding math for a number of years. So I'll be very clear. The math that we use in this class includes addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. So you will need to use a calculator sometimes because I do not condone doing division in your head. But the math is never the most important or the hardest part of what we do. The hardest part, if you think about, you know, a policy analysis, the hardest part is being sure you understand the problem and you've set the model up correctly. And that's the most important part. And then you have to do some math to solve the model, but that's not the hardest or the most important part because you can always find somebody to check your math. And then the other part of any sort of policy analysis that's also hard and more important is understanding the results and thinking through what that means and how much do you understand and do you need to look at something else. And that doesn't require any math either. We use spreadsheets in this class. And again, if you don't have experience using spreadsheets, we will teach you how. In fact, we'll have a tutorial that's designed for people who've never built a model in a spreadsheet before. And we'll teach you specifically how to use spreadsheets for the models where we use them. The most important expectation in this class is that you need to think with an open mind. For many of you, this is going to be a very new way of thinking. It's not better than the way you think. Obviously, you've been successful so far, but it is new and it will complement the way that you think. And if it doesn't come to you instantly, you'll have to be patient and have an open mind and know that you're going to get there, because this takes practice. You're going to be thinking in new ways and using new brain muscles, so to speak. And you just need to practice, and you will get a lot of practice in this class. And also, there will always be help available. We have a team of very amazing teaching assistants. They and I have office hours. So between all of us, there are office hours available every day where you can ask questions. And they also will be leading weekly optional review sessions. So there will be a lot of opportunities to ask questions and to get any kind of help that you need. The requirements for this class include, first, that you are prepared and that you participate. So that includes participating in all of the asynchronous lessons and in our live Zoom classes, and be prepared having done the required readings. You'll also have some questions and practice problems to do in those asynchronous lessons, and you'll be expected to attempt all of those. You will not be expected to get all of them correct, because as I said, you are going to learn by practicing, and making mistakes is an important part of learning here. There will be problem sets in this class. You'll work on those problem sets with study groups. You will all have study groups that you work with throughout the semester. You'll work on the problem sets together to learn together, but you will all submit your problem sets as individual work. So each person will complete each problem on each problem set. You'll have to learn how to do all of it, but you'll learn that together in your study groups. And then we also have a policy analysis memo in this class. And that's a group project that you will work on with your study group, where you'll be working on solving a real world problem throughout the semester. So as you learn new tools, you'll be applying those new tools and those new models and techniques to the problem that you're trying to solve. And at the end of the semester, you'll make a brief presentation about that to the class, and you'll submit a memo describing your policy analysis and your policy recommendations. The final requirement in this class is we will have a final exam as well. The most exciting thing about this class is that you are going to use what you learn. Everybody uses what they learn in this class. And some students use it right away in their capstones or in their internships, and some in their jobs, you know, a little longer after they've taken this class. But I hear from students, I hear from some of them right away, I hear from some of them after a bit more time, maybe 6 months or maybe a couple of years. And even those who, believe it or not, might have had some doubts, do find that they use what they learn in this class. And when we're lucky, they tell me enough about what they did, what they did when they were using what they learned in this class, so that I can actually use that to create a problem for you, either a practice problem or a problem set problem. So a lot of the problems that we do in this class are real problems that past graduates, past students from this class, have actually used what they learned in this class in their jobs. So I find that very exciting, and I hope that you do too, and I look forward to seeing you in class.